I'm Janice Edwards, coming up on Signature Silicon Valley. We are live at the San Jose Jazz Fest. The streets of San Jose are filled with music. More to come. Join us. That's next.
This segment is sponsored by Silicon Valley Community Foundation. Silicon Valley Community Foundation advances innovative philanthropic solutions to challenging problems. As the largest community foundation in the world, we engage donors and corporations from Silicon Valley, across the country, and around the globe to make our region and world better for all. Possibilities start here. Learn more at SiliconValleyCF.org.
Hi, I'm Janice Edwards, and thank you for joining us for Signature Silicon Valley. We're on location at the San Jose Jazz Fest. There's lots to enjoy. Thanks for joining us. Of the San Jose Jazz Festival. Why is it important to support this event?
Well, it's incredible because we bring people together, and at a time when our communities across the United States are so fractured, to bring people together of all ages, all races, all ethnicities, to come together and enjoy music and participate in community is so vitally important.
And I know you're a big music fan. Anybody in particular you're excited about seeing this time?
I'm excited for all of the stages. There's such a variety, and I particularly acts that I don't know because I've become acquainted with them, and then I go to iTunes to see if I can find some of their albums. So,
anything you'd like to sing for us?
No, I would. Everybody would go off the air. I am musically challenged in every respect.
You're celebrating your 10th anniversary this year. What are some of your proudest achievements?
Well, you know, certainly the foundation has had spectacular growth, but it's the work in community that's most valuable and important to me. Our work on stopping predatory payday lending in 17 communities, our work around getting a math misplacement bill passed last year by Governor Brown that ensures that every eighth grader who passes the eighth grade math is placed in ninth grade. And it's certainly a lot of work that we've done with welcoming immigrants and helping them get citizenship.
You have so many incredible things. As you look toward the next 10 years, what's on your bucket list, wish list for that?
Well, certainly the most important thing is housing. San Jose was just listed for the first city ever to have a median home price of $1 million. That is not sustainable for a healthy community. And so we have to find a way to create affordable housing in our community. And Silicon Valley Community Foundation is proud to support Santa Clara Measure A, which will help create more affordable housing units.
You have done so much work, and I know that you work very hard. Do you have a personal motto that you live by?
Live every day as if it's your last. Enjoy your family every day.
That's a great one. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
You are a board member, and why do you support San Jose Jazz? Why do you consider it important?
For 14 years, this is the most important thing that happens in San Jose. We bring everybody to the hotels, the restaurants, but the music and the children that we educate and the people, look at them, they're enjoying all of this. It's fun.
What you won't do to do for love. You tried everything, but you don't give up.
We are backstage talking with the legendary Bobby Caldwell just before he takes to the stage at the San Jose Jazz Festival. Mr. Caldwell, nice to meet you. Thank you for being here.
How are you?
I'm doing well. So you play all over the world. Why did you choose this particular venue?
Why did I choose it? Let me put an end to the misnomer that I choose locations. I'll work anywhere they pay me, okay? That's how it goes these days.
All of the Bay Area, you broke this record. God bless your hearts for doing that.
Well, your incredibly famous song, What You Won't Do for Love, is just one that I love. So many people love. What inspired that particular song?
Oh, love gone wrong, which we've all experienced, right?
Yeah.
Unrequited love, really dumped in a bad way. And so it was kind of an exorcism for me just to get it out of my system. And we all know about that. So I think that's what impacted people, because we've all been through those things.
You started your career at 17. When that song hit and it became such a huge hit, and it still is to this day, how did it change your life?
Oh my God. Well, first of all, I didn't know what was coming. I was like really green, wet behind the ears, it changed my life from an unknown to like incredible stardom. I'm not sure I was ready for that, and it took some adjusting, some learning curves. Spending money in bad places and all those things. But at the end of the day, here we are in 2016. The song still rears its head, and it's been covered by, upwards of 90 artists that have recorded the song. So it's been a blessing for me.
Is he white? Is he black? Or is it just simply 50 shades of gray? I don't know. But once that got cleared up, I don't know if that ever did. I don't know. Yeah, right? Given that I cut my teeth on the Four Tops, the Spinners, Marvin Gaye, Tammy Terrell, everything. I mean, it's kind of flattering to be counted among that bunch. So I want you all to think back to 1978. Oh my God, is it really that? I want you to think back to that year, see if this doesn't bring back some memories for you. Yeah.
Backstage with Big Russ, of course, the world famous Rick and Russ show has been keeping the crowd happy, featuring CJ Flash, want to add CJ, has been keeping the crowd happy today. It's been an amazing day at the San Jose Jazz Fest. What are your thoughts about this year?
My goodness, so much good music. I mean, Liz Wright's one of my favorites. I've been following her since Salt, so personally, I'm really, really excited. A lot of good music, and the crowd has been into it. It's been fun, and the weather was perfect. It wasn't super, super hot, but it was good. Right. You know, it was good. Yeah.
Yes,
good
it job. Wasn't that southern unsociable weather, as I call it. It was just right. So you are always traveling, always making people happy. What's new and what's on the horizon for you right now?
Well, next we have, the biggest thing we have coming up is the Concord Pavilion on the 4th. And we have a ton of tours coming up. We're very blessed. We've been able to travel the world and play music, and it's so much fun. Yeah. I'm really humbled by it. Yeah.
Tell me again, how did this all start for you?
It's a hobby. It was a hobby.
What were you doing? What were you doing? What was your day job?
I worked in healthcare for 11 years.
Really?
11 years, yeah. Okay. And then when I left, I started doing some stuff with internet companies and music. Meanwhile, the hobby was growing and growing and growing, and now this is where it is. We've turned it into terrestrial radio, internet radio, we have the merchandise, and now the touring. It's been great.
Yeah. And you and CJ, how did you two meet?
We met at a club we were both playing at. And we had a common friend, Positively Red. He came in with him one day and met Rick and I, and we instantly bonded as brothers, and then we started working together. He had his own company called Music for the People, and we kind of folded that into what we were doing and built it, and it's been growing. It's been great. So it's his company and the world-famous Rick and Russ show, so now it's this one thing. It's very cool.
What have you seen in terms of music changing over the last few years?
Oh, God. That's a slippery slope. Because we don't have music in the schools, we're actually seeing that now, where all the songs are sounding the same. There's some really good people out there, you know, Roe James, and some of the current people out there are good, but for the most part, some of it is real stagnant because there's no incubator for it. So, but luckily we have music like this, and that's why we play a lot of old school R&B, old soul, soulful house music. We play a lot of that stuff, and it just you can see people's face just light up when they hear the music, that it's real music, and they really love it. Not to discount what's going on right now, not to discount it, but we just need more of that. We need more of those young lions coming up with new music. You know, like Guaple, Sister was here today. I mean, good new music, Lettucey, Guaple. The Bay is really looking good right now.
Oh, I know, they're amazing. And I had them both on Bay Area Vista years ago, and just to see what's happened to them, and they're still, their souls and their spirits are still so gracious.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Do you have a personal motto that you live by?
Just be good to people. Just really be, I tell people, you know what, I'm trying to get to heaven. If you can help me get to heaven, whatever I can do to help you, I'm good.
That's
Yeah, that's really what works for me.
Well, clearly people are always excited. I know we posted something on social media to let people know about this. They said, wow, you're going to be there with Big Russ? He's the man to know. So we're glad that you took time to talk with us. It, on your bucket list, what's on there? I mean, you've done a lot of things that you wanted to do, but
oh,
what's
my God. Oh, my bucket list. Wow. That's, ooh. Bucket list, I've always wanted to play Ibiza. I've never played there. I want to open up for Incognito. Bucket list, which is crazy. I opened up for Stevie, which was on the list. That was very cool.
How was Stevie?
That was great. I had an out-of-body experience. It was really cool. And then all of a sudden I realized, that's Stevie Wonder right there. You know, then I kind of bugged out for a minute. It was cool. Yeah.
Wow,
very blessed.
Yes. Well, you are blessed and you're a blessing. It's good to see you. And thanks so much for the music that you bring to make our lives.
Great job. Great job. People love you.
Thank you. Well, they love you too, and I'm really excited to work with you guys. So thanks so much. Always good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Oh, if you'd like to contact and find out how to get in contact with the world famous Rick and Russ show, details are on our screen. Sandra Daly is the owner of Sandy's Cobbler Cups. They've been very popular here at the San Jose Jazz Fest. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Congratulations on your continuing success. A couple
Thank
years
you.
Ago, we had you on the show when you were just starting at Levi's Stadium. So what's happened
yes.
since then?
Yes. So since then, I'm still doing Levi's Stadium. They've now contracted with me to do gumbo. So I take 8 gallons of gumbo to the stadium every Friday. So that's been a fun activity, and I've been doing lots of catering, and this is 'tis the season for festivals. So today here at San Jose Jazz, next month at Monterey Jazz, and on Wednesdays I do Sunnyvale, and the cobblers are really, really good this year. Good fresh fruit, and my new item is gumbo. So I've always had jambalaya and red beans and rice, and just trying to stay busy.
Well, you're staying busy and keeping people happy with delicious items. So who taught you this recipe? How did you learn your cobbler recipe?
Oh, my grandmother. And it's just her secret is, I'm not going to tell you, but...
come on, Sandy.
The crust okay. is the secret. Okay. And then the peach filling, and I just trial and error, and I just kept on modifying it, and the crust is just to die for.
I had my first one today, and
yes.
she is right. Oh my goodness, it's so good. And everyone on our crew can attest to that as well. It's quite
thank
delicious.
You so much. I'm glad you guys are here. There's lots of fun food throughout the whole festival. And we're just having a great time, and we'll be here till 11 tonight. And I'm also hosting Cobbler Tasting in the VIP booth.
Awesome.
Yes.
That's great.
So that's today, all this afternoon, and it'll be there tomorrow. And then people are coming over here after getting a taste and purchasing the cobblers.
Yes. You're also vice president of the Black Leadership Cabinet in
yes.
Santa Clara. Tell us a little bit about that for people who don't know.
Okay, so the Black Leadership Kitchen Cabinet, BLKC, it's a group of professionals that we get together every month. Every first Thursday, and we talk about issues within the African American community and community of color, and we talk about issues that are affecting our children, our jobs, and we have guest speakers, and we're learning from each other, a lot of great networking. And last week we met with the mayor, Sam McCardo, and so what we do is we send questions to them and all of our guests, and they are prepared to answer our questions and address some of the community concerns. And it's just something we've done since 2005. And I'm co-chair with Andre Chapman, and we just meet with all the community and we talk about issues. So with so much going on in the country right now, we want to make sure that we are being represented and supported from all sources, not just our jobs, but from the police force, from education, and just knowing that we are a community. We embrace all community and we work together as a team.
Well, that's great to know. And we have contact information on the screen, both for Sandy's Cobbler Cups as well as for the BLKC.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. And what's your favorite part of the festival, in addition to people coming to the booth?
But just seeing everybody. You know, I mean, I'm born and raised here in the Bay Area, so everybody comes together, and just so many faces, and just being able to see everybody and watch the faces after they're eating not just my food, but everybody's. So it's just so enjoyable.
That's great. Thank you. Have just finished an incredible performance. We're talking with Vaud now as he catches a breath, takes a sip, and reflects. How was this performance for you today?
Oh, it was really fun. You know, we're an old rock and roll band, so playing at noon is a bit of a challenge, but the crowd was wonderful and the festival vibe is fantastic, so we had a great time.
Let's talk about how you came up with the name Vaud and the Villains.
My wife and I were getting married and had been a part of some interesting acting projects as actors, and beautiful projects, and we wanted to create something that was really beautiful and didn't know what it was. And we were really inspired by the Springsteen Seeger Sessions album and band, and we just thought, what if we created a show with something like that? And we started from that springboard and started thinking about interesting things we could do with it, and my grandma used to dance in vaudeville shows and cabarets and revues and stuff, and so my mind sort of went there, and I don't know how Vaud and the Villains came about, but it somehow did, and there was a ton of other horrible names that we rejected, but we knew immediately that was the one, and then, oh, it informed everything. It was like, oh, this, everyone will have a name, like an interesting villain name, and everyone, then sometimes we'll talk about them in the show, and sort of came, the whole show was sort of born out of picking that for the name.
Well, your love of theater clearly comes through with all of this, which is great. So I know you're performing 3 times in the Bay Area today, and of all the places you perform, what's been the pinnacle so far that you've been most excited about?
That's really hard to say, because to be totally sincere with you, the Big Easy stage we're going to is the most exciting one right now, because we love doing the show so much. We love playing our songs and the other song, you know, the old traditionals and stuff. So it's really the fact that we get to do it at all is just a big con. I can't believe it. It's amazing. Like we played amazing places. We've been at Cannes, France, a Cannes Film Festival, and the Hollywood Bowl, and we've been all over the U.S. But it's every single one is special and unique, and you know, the big crowds are amazing, but the crowds of 20 people where people are crying when you're singing a song, you can't buy that.
I noticed the take on the Beatles songs that was unique. Choose the arrangements that you put together.
We always said we wanted it to be fun and sexy, not like burlesque and, you know, in your face sexy, but just sort of fun, sexy, and uplifting. So those three words sort of inform everything we do in choosing material and how things go and trying to bring people together and make people feel good.
What's your experience so far at the San Jose Jazz Festival? What would you tell people who've never been here before?
I would say it's a great festival to come to. I see a lot of, I haven't seen any too much behind the backstage other than the backstage, but I see there's a lot of tents, a lot of people are here. It's definitely a family-friendly event. It seems like people are walking the streets, having a good time. They're eating, they're drinking. Who doesn't want to do that at a festival? I mean, that's a given.
Toni Nabe has been a guest on Signature Silicon Valley before. She is an entrepreneur, published author, inspirational and motivational speaker, and here at the Jazz Festival, nice to see you. How's it been being here?
It's been fantastic. We have enjoyed not just the people, but also, you know, the musicians. The music has been wonderful. Being able to even see the different artists and just the same repeats. It's been wonderful just to hear and experience downtown San Jose again.
And as you are experiencing this, what do you think this means for the community in terms of commerce and having a festival like this here?
I think it's huge. I think there's a few things that go on. Number one, it does bring people back together. You've got a lot of people from diverse backgrounds that come to this event on an annual basis. But from a standpoint of being able to generate revenue, you've got, you know, restaurants, you've got retail shops in here that are going to be, you know, bringing in dollars that they wouldn't necessarily get without having so many people coming from all around the nation. So I think it's a great event and it's powerful for the community, not only community building, but also from a revenue generation standpoint.
Great. Well, it's always great to see you. Thanks so much for stopping backstage.
Thank you.
And it's been an incredible day here at the San Jose Jazz Fest. That's our show. I'm Janice Edwards. Thanks for putting your signature on our valley in an incredible way. Please join us again next time. We look forward to seeing you then.
This segment is sponsored by Silicon Valley Community Foundation. Silicon Valley Community Foundation advances innovative philanthropic solutions to challenging problems. As the largest community foundation in the world, we engage donors and corporations from Silicon Valley, across the country, and around the globe to make our region and world better for all. Possibilities start here. Learn more at siliconvalleycf.org.